So how does this work? Short answer is we really don't know. We thought we knew, but it's like many things, the more you learn about it, the more questions you have. We know that the stimulation only gets out, at least therapeutically, just a couple of millimeters from the electrodes. We're really talking about a small area. And it's not stimulating brain cells, it's stimulating the wiring. The brain, we don't have enough, there's not enough power in the system to stimulate the brain cells themselves, but it stimulates the wires, whichever way they're going. So clearly it has remote effects too. And for a long time, because the same targets responded to deep brain stimulation that had formerly been the ablation targets, like in the thalamus or the globus pallidus, people thought, well, it must be just we're making a hole temporarily while the stimulation is on. It would shut down the activity of that center. Turns out it doesn't. Then that was actually discovered in our laboratories too with our patients using microelectrode recording. We found that the activity in those targets, this happens to be the subthalamic nucleus, but continued right through stimulation. But what it did was it sort of changed the message. It's sort of like the music was still there, but the tune was different. And I won't go into detail on that, but that's basically what we found in that target. And the other one that we use quite frequently, globus pallidus, same thing. And it wasn't that one thing happened. It was multiple types of things. Sometimes the cells, the neurons would follow along at the same frequency as the stem. Sometimes they would be inhibited and then rebound. Sometimes they would have no effect. So the final answer on how this works is yet to be shown. There's no question that it does work. It's just a question of how at this point. So to summarize, a lot of, you know, literally 20 years of research, it does seem to inhibit certain brain cells. It changes the message, though. It changes what they're doing. And it has effects that are not only right around the electrode, but also projected to that side of the brain and even the other side of the brain remotely from the from the stimulation. And we know that by PET studies and functional MRI studies, where we can see the whole brain at once during stimulation. It doesn't produce a hole. The cells are still active. They're just sending out a different message. And we've looked actually at patients that have passed away, you know, after living a long life, and looked at the tracks and where the electrodes were. We see no accumulation of a lesion. It's not like stimulation over a period of time gradually produces a hole.